the definite method to remove the shields from the motherboard. Hello everyone, I'm Adriana and today Leonardo is giving to you the opportunity to learn about an effective method to remove the shields from the motherboard. Today in our hands we've got two mini Dremels, also known as precision cutting tools. Soon we'll reveal which of these two tools is superior, so I recommend you to pay attention to the video. If you professionally dedicate yourself to mobile repair, I believe that due to their cost, these tools are essential in your laboratory. Now we are going to test the second mini Dremel to see what differences we can observe. Just by holding it, I can already perceive that it has a higher weight and seems more robust. Let's see how it cuts and then with the help of the microscope we will be able to analyze the result in more detail. To the microscope to examine the cuts closely. The truth is, it cuts quite well, all through the times it takes to cut a shield seems a bit prolonged to me. As I always say, time is gold in our work. Once you've made cuts on the sides of the shield, you can easily remove it with cutting pliers. You just have to make small cuts along the edge of the metal sheet. Here I leave my opinion, which is personal and may not be valid for everyone. In my experience, I prefer to remove shields using the hot air. High temperature and the high air flow are applied for a very short time. However, I still consider it essential to have a precision Dremel in your workshop. Throughout the weeks, there are times when you'll need to make tiny cuts in screws, some small shields, and the like. We definitely need a Dremel in our workshop. If you like our content, give it a strong like, and this way you'll contribute a grain of sand to our project. Thank you. Now we are going to demonstrate our method of removing the shields using the hot air station. I use a temperature of 400 Celsius degrees with 80% airflow. In just 30 seconds we have the shield off of the motherboard. For me, this is the best method for removing the motherboard's shields. Of course, you need to have a bit of experience and overcome the initial fear. With this method, you won't overheat the motherboard because the temperature of the circuits won't reach the melting point of 220 Celsius degrees. The trick is to work without a nozzle to distribute the heat over a wider area and move the nozzle in circles. Guys, that's all for today. Here's Leonardo. We hope we've learned something new today and we wait for you in the next video. Bye bye!